There are many aspects of COVID-19 that make it difficult to track within a community. And yet, being able to accurately measure the spread of the virus is absolutely crucial to the well-being of the entire community.
And cities around the world, especially in the United States and Europe, have all spent billions and billions of dollars to connect each one of our homes to a centralized treatment plant. All we have to do is flush a toilet, it goes down a drain, it runs through sewers, it eventually ends up in a sewage treatment plant where it is concentrated for us and all mixed together. So one sample, in this case, can be the equivalent of a couple hundred thousand people. And so you can get a sense of what's going on with them just through that.
Wastewater surveillance is a method that has been used before as a public health surveillance tool.
We wanted to focus in New Haven for a few reasons. The first reason is this is our community. It's an ideal place to do this. We have a top quality wastewater treatment plant. It serves a specific confined known amount of people where we also have testing data for. So we're picking up a sample really every day from the New Haven wastewater treatment plant. This is the primary sludge. So dirty water comes in, clean water comes out, the dirt, quote unquote, the chunks and everything else that can settle to the bottom, get treated in a different stream. Altogether, those are collectively known as sewage sludge. That's where you usually find the highest concentrations of pathogens, of heavy metals, of all sorts of nasty things that get into sewage.
And so the process of extracting the virus from the sludge is, by its very nature, full of inconsistencies. But Dr. Peccia's team has refined a system that has given some answers.
So this is a massive collaboration with people at the university, and this is certainly a project that could be done poorly by anybody, but to be done well, I think it has to be done by a large group of people. And the person that's really leading this is Saad Omer, who's the Director of Global Health Institute at Yale University. He's an epidemiologist. He's got past experience with the polio sewage surveillance as well. We're also working with Ed Kaplan at the School of Management, who has lots of experience with these types of outbreaks. But I want to mention also, you know, we've gotten students involved that are in my lab right now extracting RNA from sewage.
With the current challenges of testing a community, this type of surveillance can provide valuable data that could inform public health policy.
So we're all used to looking at these shapes of the curve, you know, the curve you want to flatten. We're going to get that curve in sewage as well. And what we're finding so far, preliminarily, is that the curve we get is earlier than the curve that you get from testing, whether people know they're sick or not. Everybody's worried that if we stop social distancing at some date, it's going to go back up. If it does, we think we'll see that in the sewage and we want to be ready. Pick any entity that you want in the city of New Haven or in any city, somewhere where people want to know, well, is it showing up in my area? Sewage can be a leading indicator of that.